Japanese art. Aikido's founder, Morihei Ueno-sensei, studied the use of steps, including the staff, and incorporated what he learned into the art he created. Mitsugi Saotome-sensei is a direct student of Ueno-sensei. Born in Japan in 1937, Saotome-sensei began his study of Aikido at the age of 19. In 1960, he entered Aikikai Honbu Dojo, Aikido World Headquarters, as an Uchideshi or live-in student, a position that he held for 15 years. Saotome-sensei often traveled with Ueno-sensei and served as his partner in demonstrations. Like other students of Aikido's founder, Saotome-sensei watched Ueno-sensei's spontaneous movements with Jo and attempted to organize what he saw into a coherent training system. Saotome-sensei also trained under Ueno-sensei's son, Kisumaru Ueshiba, Aikido's present head or Doshu. For about 6 years after the founder's death, Saotome-sensei stayed on in Tokyo as an instructor at Aikikai Honbu Dojo. In 1975, Saotome-sensei moved to the United States. Several years later, he established Aikido Schools of Ueshiba, one of America's largest Aikido organizations. In 1994, Saotome-sensei's friends and students gathered in Washington, D.C. to commemorate his 40th year in Aikido. The celebration, which coincided with Washington's annual Cherry Blossom Festival, included workouts and demonstrations, such as this one. At the Cherry Blossom Festival, Saotome-sensei received many commendations for his work in spreading and preserving Aikido, including a letter from Doshu Kisumaru Ueshiba and a letter from President Bill Clinton. Why train with obsolete weapons such as wooden staff? One part of Saotome-sensei's answer is that training with these weapons teaches lessons that we can apply to empty-handed Aikido techniques. Lessons about timing, distancing, connection, and entering. Also, training weapons can be equalizers. When partners work with Joes, differences of size and strength dwindle in importance. Finally, when we train with weapons such as Joes, we must confront our opponents face to face and acknowledge the disastrous consequences of carelessness or excessive aggression. Training with weapons can therefore develop control and compassion, helping us to improve not just our bodies, but our minds and spirits as well.
Basic Jo movement.
Unlike the sword, which is primarily a cutting and slashing weapon, the wooden staff, or Jo, is primarily a thrusting weapon. When thrusting with a Jo, it's important to allow it to slide freely through the front hand. If the front grip is too tight, the thrust will lack power. Power is also lost if the hands come too close together, or if the source of motion is the upper body. The origin of the thrusting motion should be the lower body, the hips. Obviously, the Joe's Q-tips are identical, and this accounts for its characteristic movement. Having come forward with one end of the Joe, we can turn our bodies and come forward with the other end. In such movement, front and back alternate fluidly, working together like yin and yang.
Show exercise number one.
In this exercise, the partners mirror one another's movements. First, the partners thrust towards one another's hearts. If the thrust is weak, or the hands come too close together, it may be hard to defend against a secondary attack. In contrast, if the thrust is forceful and the hands are properly spaced, it will be easy to move to a defensive position or to launch a second attack. The complete pattern can be practiced continuously. Thrust. Thrust. Yokuman strike. Yokuman. Back thrust. Strike to the leg. Turning the Joe over leaves the partners ready to repeat the pattern on the other side.
Joe exercise number two.
The second Joe exercise illustrates the flow of offense to defense and from defense back to offense. At first glance, it may seem that the exercise's initial movement has two distinct parts, a thrust followed by a parry. In fact, the movement is a continuous entering spiral. The attempt to strike an attacking Joe out of the way may create defensive problems. When practicing this exercise, it's best not to think about pushing the opponent's Joe out of the way, but to view the opponent's Joe as a guide, leading directly into the opponent's center line. A slight deflection leaves the opponent's Joe offline, making it possible to move past its tip and to enter. In this exercise, a single entering spiral serves both defensive and offensive purposes, deflecting the opponent's attack while opening the opponent to counterattack.
Joe exercise number three.
This exercise, like the last, illustrates the interplay of offense and defense. At the start of the pattern, Satome-sensei lifts his Joe to deflect his partner's thrust. If the Joe comes up in front of him, the attack may still succeed. So it's important for him to move outside the initial thrust. Having moved to the side, Satome-sensei finds his opponent open to a yokuman side-head strike. This Yokomen strike can itself be blocked by a movement similar to that made in response to the initial attack. Here, for obvious reasons, it's important for the head to be beneath the Jo.
The six basic Kumi Jo.
Having studied O-sensei's movement, Satome-sensei developed a training system for the Jo. At the heart of this system are six set patterns, or Kumijo Kata, each of which has several variations. At first glance, it may seem that partners going through these kata are training to fight with staves. In fact, they are studying the art and spiritual discipline of Aikido, just as they would if training with empty hands. Through the Jo training, students develop Aiki, connection with the energy of a partner, and ultimately, with the energy of the universe. Here are the six basic patterns, shown once in real time and once in slow motion.
Kumi Jo number one.
Often, when people see Kumi Jo number one, they wonder why the initial defender grips the Jo in such a peculiar way. The explanation is that in these patterns, the Jo is used as a walking stick. Other ways of gripping a walking stick would be awkward and unnatural. The first movement of Kumi Jo number one is important for empty-handed training as well as for weapons practice. In this movement, the right hand, which is at the back of the Jo, makes a large circle, as the left hand anchors the Jo movement. The left hand then makes a smaller circle in the same direction. The resulting spiral deflects the opponent's attack while simultaneously opening the opponent to counterattack. If the forward left hand moves too far offline, the defense may only be temporary. If the forward hand stays online, defense may lead directly to offense. The initial spiral of Kumjo number 1 illustrates the principle of Ikkyo, Aikido's fundamental technique. The timing, the direction, and the shape of the spiral, even the details of the hand position, are the same as in open-handed Ikkyo technique.
Kumijo number 1, first variation.
Each of the basic 6 Kumijo kata have several variations. Here, for instance, Satomi Sensei demonstrates a pattern that differs from Kumijo number 1 only in its final movement.
Kumijo number 1, second variation. Kumijo number 1, third variation. Kumijo number 2.
Kumijo number 2 differs from Kumijo number 1 in its point of attack. While the second attack of Kumijo number 1 is a thrust to the side, in Kumijo number 2, it is a strike to the knee. In Kumijo number 1, the defender's jaw moves to cover his side. In Kumijo number 2, it drops to cover the leg.
Kumijo number 2, first variation.
Instead of a thrust, this variation ends with a move resembling Ikkyo. The other two variations of this Kumijo pattern also end with movements resembling common Aikido techniques.
Kumijo number 2, second variation. Kumijo number 2, third variation. Kumijo number
the first movement of Kumijo number 3 is a thrust to the knee. Moving Turning to his left and covering with his jo, Satome-sensei leaves his left side open to a thrust, which he avoids by moving back to his right. His strike here could have been to his opponent's hand, but for safety in practice, it is to his opponent's jo. The basic training point of Kumi-jo number 3 is moving side to the side to defend against an attack. Notice also that when striking his opponent's jo, Satome-sensei's jo is horizontal, not tilted downward.
Kumi-jo number 3, first variation. Kumi-jo number 3, second variation. Kumi-jo number 3, third variation. Kumi-jo number 4.
The initial attack in Kumi-jo number 4 is a thrust between the eyes, much higher than in the previous Kumi-jo pattern. The second attack is a thrust to the side. What makes jo training unique is that when one end of the jo is used defensively, the other end can come into offensive position.
Kumi-jo number 4, first variation. Kumi-jo number 4, second variation. Kumi-jo number 5.
The idea behind Kumi-jo number 5 is that the defender swings his jo with his body movement. At close range, this move can be difficult and dangerous. So in practice, the defender drops back away from his opponent. The jo is then swung forward and around into hasso position. As his opponent attacks into the apparent opening, Satome-sensei moves to the side and thrusts.
Kumi-jo Number 5, First Variation. Kumijo, number 5, Second Variation. Kumijo, number 5, Third Variation. Kumijo, number 6.
This pattern begins like Kumijo number 1 and 2. When attacked for a second time, however, the offender draws back, withdraws his jo, and then strikes upward for his opponent's elbow. In contrast to what happens in the other 5 patterns, in this Kumijo, the attacker wins.
Kumijo number 6, First Variation.
This variation differs from the primary pattern in the position of Sawatome Sensei's jo after the upward strike to the opponent's elbow.
Kumijo number 6, Second Variation. Kumijo number 6, Third Variation. The 6 Basic Kumijo, a review.
think two souls is very interesting. So then, yin yang, or two hands go help each other, yin yang, separate. But kumijo is the one jo, both sides use, and, you know, spinning. So this is a very interesting concept. And, so, kumitachi is more direct place. Kumijo is more studying, you know, directly, but always in the end it comes, moving. Also, kumijo, the distance, more than the soul, jo is very more wide distance. This is show using ukemi bambambam, very spontaneous. So why maybe sometime, I'm teaching kumitachi, kumijo, a little different to other parts because this is spontaneous, a different experience. My experience to Ukemi Do Sensei, another Shihan taking Ukemi Do Sensei, maybe different time, you know, different ages, always memory is different. But honestly, I try to organize my memory. This is using sword is not just sword technique. He's explained use Aikido. It's a tool, you know. Showing Aikido is. He's not playing sword, not playing jo. He's showing to, the kind of Aikido image. He's showing something. Right? So Boken, jo, is a training tool.
The bow and the patrol kata.
Jo is different size jo. This is our ordinary walking stick time. And this long is called a bow. Jo is more. So, in the century, the city guard, city police, guarding house, the government used this size, jaw. So we call a cage. Cage means the police or guardman.
Unlike the shorter jo, the bow is held under the arm, as if one were on patrol. Because of the bow's length, its movements differ somewhat from those of the standard jo, but the basic principles are the same. As one end of the bow comes forward, the other can recede, in a movement resembling the smooth alternation of yin and yang. A guardsman with a bow might be called on to face an opponent armed with a sword. Here, to defend against a swordsman, Satomi-sensei moves to the side and enters, much as he would when practicing empty-handed Aikido technique. Bow's spinning, spiral movements make it an extremely powerful defensive weapon. A good swordsman might be able to cut through a bow. So rather than blocking, the guardsman must avoid the sword.
Patrol kata number one.
Satome-sensei has developed a system of paired kata based on bow movement. Frank Bell of the Sarasota Aikikai and Kevin Choate of the Chicago Aikikai will demonstrate 10 of these kata using the shorter staffs commonly found in Aikido dojo.
Patrol kata number two. Patrol kata number three. Patrol kata number four. Patrol